In the ninth problem, you are asked again to prepare trading and profit and loss account. I'm not going to do the problem, but whatever is important and which we have not covered in the previous problems, I'm just going to give you tips or what you say. You can underline those and take in concerned place as what I say, or I shall put it here. I'll just roughly say, here is my trading account ending. So whatever is the trading account item, if at all we have not come across previously, I'll be writing in this part, and similarly I'll be writing profit and loss account items below here. Now you have, I'll just quickly run through the items which we have already come across in the previous problems. The ones which we have not come across, I'll discuss. Opening stock, purchases, carriage, wages, salaries, clearing charges. Next item is furniture. But if you remember, furniture is a real account. We are not going to enter any real account in trading or P&L account, because already discussed, capital expenditure, which represents real accounts, will appear only in balance sheet. So remember to ignore furniture while you prepare. You can just strike it out or underline or circle it. Next, the other items already we discussed. Similarly, bad debts, discount allowed, sales expenses, etc. will come in your P&L account. Then coming to, again, machinery. Being a real account, it will not appear in trading or P&L account. Import duty. Import duty, you can show it in your trading account debit side. Import duty, suppose if it is mentioned import duty relate to sales, then it will go to P&L account. Then sales returns, you know, advertisement, you know, interest paid will appear in P&L account. If you have not come across this, interest paid will always come in P&L debit. The next, you have your trade expenses, you know, they'll appear in P&L account. Oil and fuel, it will appear in trading account. Oil and fuel, they'll appear in your trading account. And rent will appear in P&L account. Carriage will appear in trading account. So some of the items we have run through. Let us see the other items. Credit balances are given. Capital, as you know, is a personal account. So there is no place for personal and real accounts in trading and P&L. Again, I reiterate, only nominal accounts come in trading and P&L account. You know, discount received, rent received will come in P&L account. Sales will come in trading account. Return outwards is purchase returns, therefore it should be deducted from purchase returns. Then you have dividend on shares. Dividend on shares is an indirect income, so you will be taking dividend on shares on the credit side of your P&L account. So dividend on shares on the credit side of P&L account. So this way, try to complete the problem and be sure that you have taken all the amounts.